They have actually had like this game I'm playing, because it's called Fallout 76, which is basically Fallout 76. And in the just gotta back off, that guy might kill me. They got basically in like the storyline and stuff like that. This is one of the Fallout 76 is one of the first vaults to open up after the world went nuclear. Like, there's a whole big Great War that happened back in like 67 or something in that era, where China invades Alaska, everybody goes crazy, everybody throws nukes around, kind of like what's going on in the world right now with Putin threatening to nuke everybody, you know, all that stuff. There's a lot to take into. Like, if you don't know anything about like the game wise, you'll enjoy the Amazon show Fallout. You'll probably learn a bit from that, because they do some stuff, but me as a fan who knows this world inside and out, I don't like the show, because they screw up a lot for me that I don't like. But it is what it is. Like, there's a lot to dive into, type thing, if you, even if you're hearing me. They ended up creating, there's a company called Vault Tech, which, if you dig into it, they're responsible for the whole Great War that made this world, because they wanted to make these vaults. Not for survival, but for experiments. And, like, for an example, like, Vault 12, excuse me, for the experiments, had a problem with their door not sealing, so these higher-up people could see what the effects of radiation would do to humans. Like, stuff like that. They'll do things where they, like, take power away and see how you're gonna survive without power, or take... or screw up your ration, like, you know what I mean? Like, they just do everything. It's just... it's a sick world when you find out about it all. Like, it's one of the games I could sit here and talk, like, lore things for it for days and days and days while I play. I've been playing... like, this is the fifth game in the series. Oh, I'm on area. Whoops. Sorry to everyone in the world. I didn't realize I was on area. I'm streaming and I was talking to my chat. I apologize for bleeding through to everyone. Yeah, so, like, this one here is a multiplayer game. Like, I'm strictly online with this one. It's what we call, like, an MMO, which means for a massive multiplayer online type game. Like, I know you're driving, so you can't see everything I'm shooting at, but there's these little white dots that are on the map, and those are other players and stuff like that. We can help each other out. I have it on passive mode, so I can't be attacked know what I mean, by other players, but if I take passive mode off, I can find guys who are like level 600 against my level 30 and just destroy me type thing, you know what I mean? So you get some griever players who just want to ruin everybody else's experience and stuff like that. And like, to go back on, does it have it, like, this one does have a completion. It's got some like story aspect to it where you can go complete some stories to it in the game, but the game itself doesn't have like an end credits, if that's what you're thinking of. It doesn't have like a beginning, a middle, and a doesn't have your intro, your main story, like I can't think of the story structure right now. Wow, I fail English hard. You know what I mean? Like, it's. I don't know. I like less complicated games. No, it's not really a lot of work. It can be a lot for someone who doesn't know about the survival. You know what I mean? Like, you have to break down stuff. You have to repair stuff. It can be very overwhelming if you don't have someone who's going to sit there and like break it down and stuff. But you can ask Tolga and James that if you actually want to learn, all you have to do is ask. And I could sit here on this thing and teach you the best I could while you drove, in a way. But I don't want to do that because, you know, you could be driving. I don't want to distract you and stuff like that. If you wanted to get into Fallout, I would look into getting Fallout 4 and just learning with that game. It's a single player game. It's the one that was just out before this one. It just got the next gen treatment, so it's on new systems. If anyone in your family's got the new Xbox, the new PlayStation 5 or whatever, you know what I mean? Like that type of thing. If not, it won't hurt you to go down and play it on a PS4, you know what I'm saying? If you want to play a game, look for Fallout 4, even Fallout 3. Those are great games for someone who wants to get into the game. Actually, no. Scratch that. Get Fallout New Vegas. That is a fantastic game. But yeah, no, like, if you're someone who wants to just do, like, a casual game, even, like, you want to do casuals and stuff, right? So, okay, good. I was just making through. I was coming through on my stream. I had to play there for a second. Yeah. So, what were you saying there? Oh, good, less complicated game. Yeah, like, two daughters of mine are diehard. Oh, two. Okay, well, two of your daughters might actually know about this then if they're hardcore gamers. I didn't even read that line. Good for them. That's cool. Need more gamer girls in the world. But yeah, like, who knows? Maybe one of your daughters already plays the game and could help you through it. There's lots of people playing. Like, there's another game this company makes is called Skyrim or Elder Scrolls, which is a fantasy version of like what I am. Like, I'm in the wastelands trying to survive. You're in a medieval war. They made a game called Skyrim, and there was she's called like Skyrim Granny on YouTube, I think is what she was called. She was like 80 something years old or 70 something, and she was playing Skyrim every day, and she's been immortalized in the game now. They made a character for her in that, like, Bethesda Studios actually put her in the game. There's a couple, there's a guy in Fallout 4 who, his brother passed away, and they made him an NPC in the character to honor his brother. There's some quests around in some of the games to honor fallen past members and stuff like that. And yeah, it's a really cool, like, Bethesda's a really cool like franchise to get involved with if you ever thought about branching off into something that's a tid more adventurous than like maybe playing, like, I don't know, Mario Kart or Tetris, you know what I mean? But like you said, it could be too complicated. And not everybody wants complication when they play a game. They want to go and have fun. That's when you meet someone like me, who can take the complication, teach you how to make it fun, and forget the complicated part. Like me right now, all I'm doing in this game, I'm looking for a type of plant that's called bleached dogwood so I can make water filters. like there's a lot of in this game to do. Like you got to break down, like you got carry weight that affects you when you're going stuff. Like here, I know you can't see it, but nah, no, I got it on purple. It won't show up too well. I can only carry 200 pounds, right? Or 220 pounds worth of weight, and that doesn't really help someone considering that I'm barely running around with stuff that's on me now, and I'm at 115 pounds of weight, and that's just basically for stuff I'm carrying, like weapons, armor, stuff like that. So it's got a management. There is a, like, as you can see on the, I don't know how well you can see, I got a meter there for it shows a fork and a knife and water droplets. You do have a hunger and a thirst meter, but you only get bonuses if it's full. It doesn't cripple you like it used to when it was empty. So that's why you don't see me filling it now. I don't bother. I don't need to. But the thing with, like, even this Fallout 76 game, because it's online with people, I find it's even a good one to get into if you just want to go around and do what you're going to do. Like, the game will teach you the basic. Oh, okay, you have PS4, there you go.
PS5, I don't have a PS4, I'm looking for something better because I've played the shit.
Oh, played the shit out of COD. Oh, okay, something. What you should get then, look for Ghosts of Tsushima. Here, I'll type it in there. I think I spelled that right. I might have spelled it wrong, but it is. I think I spelled that wrong. I don't have the game case in front of me. but yeah, no, it's a single player game. It's about the Mongol invasion of Japan, and you're playing a samurai. That's all I want to say about it. And I recommend that game to anyone and everyone who's on a PS4 to PS5. It is one of the best made games I have ever played. And I mean ever played. Like, if you don't mind, like, you can set it on some easy modes and stuff to make it a little easy. Like, you're just going around with a samurai sword. You got, like, a grappling hook at some point. You can throw some, like, you know, kunais and, like, samurai stuff, you know? It's real. It's kind of like make-believe, but it's more about the Mongol invasion when they invaded Japan back in 16th century, I think. I don't know. But that's a really good one to get into. Let me see here. You can get Farming Simulator. No, I'm just kidding. You can be a farmer on PlayStation. what are some good ones? You don't like complicated, but you want something that's going to be... That's where it gets tricky for me, because I like the difficult challenges of video games and stuff, right? That's the type of gamer I am. I'm in it for the grind, the long haul, you know? Something that I can start and I know I'm going to have, like, hundreds of hours in, even if it takes me 5 years to play. Fuck the farmers, truckers rule the world. Right? But that trucking simulator... American Truck Simulator there on PC. It's not coming to console. That's why I say you can get Farming Sim. It's on PC.
Oh, that's funny, kid. I'm back to my bleached wood.
Oh, get this, Brian. If you're on Facebook, apparently now Meta, the company behind Facebook, as of March, is going to start banning people who use vulgar fucking language. That's apparently what fucking Meta's going to start doing on YouTube. And all I commented on mine was, on that was, well, fucking hell, I can't believe you're going to fucking do that to us. Like, oh, well, goodbye, fucking Facebook. Like, Oh, did you drop it 2 years ago? Oh, okay. I didn't know that. I'm... Yeah, I know, right? They're...
What the hell?
Why isn't chat showing up?
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, if I had to scream, I'd know where you were.
Someone come through here and get all the bleached already? Like, I don't... It's all down here, not up here, right? Because it's going fucking non-bleached. level 5 weapons in a level 30 area don't do well. Fucking love when the game glitches like this. Scrap the goddamn 20-year-old engine already, Bethesda. Make something for current gen. Level 5 weapon in a level 30 area. Yeah, I haven't upgraded any of my weapons since I started fucking 3 days ago when I played the game. Level 1 freaking pistol, level 5 shotgun. It's what I use right now. I just haven't bothered to upgrade. Why? Because it's not on my priority list. One thing, if you're going to be watching me play, I don't give two fucks about the meta. I don't take backseat gaming from anyone, and I play how I want to and the way I want to, and I always fucking will be. Oh, and you better watch out for your own feelings, because I don't protect them. This is an unfiltered type channel too, so just be aware. Yeah, have you seen how much is Cetharian? So look in my bottom right corner, dude. Tell me how much ammo my shotgun's holding. You think I'm worried about it? I can craft my own ammo. I'm not a noob to Fallout, buddy. I'm 43 years old. I've been playing Fallout since 1. I know more about Fallout than probably most people learned watching that stupid show. There's my ammo count for you, buddy. 1,299 shotgun, almost 610 millimeters. I can go make that up to 5,000 shotgun and probably 5,010 millimeters if you're really that worried about my bullet count, dude, because you don't see me stressing about it, right? You're the one that's worried about it, not moi. Fuck, no, I'm stuck. Aha, Skyrim navigate that bitch. Aha, fuck you, follow. And I honestly would have better weapons if I found the plans for it, man. Like, I went to go craft some, and I'm stuck craft with these, like, weapons right now. So until I find better shit, you know, that's the only reason I say it how it is. I don't have the stuff to craft, so I'm kind of fucked. I do got my little brother who jumps on and plays and shit like that, and he said the same shit fucking 2 days ago, too, right? So that's all. Spend as many hours as I did playing freaking Dark Souls, a level 1 with a fucking broken dagger, running around naked, you know, running around with 1,200 freaking or a level 5 shotgun. But it is kind of funny taking a level 1 and a level freaking 5 gun to a level 50 freaking event. Should have heard area chat when I was doing that. And if anyone's still watching, you're basically catching me doing a farming thing right now. I wasn't doing anything too exciting. I'm in this area looking for bleached dogwood. I've gotten a bunch, but after that, I'm going to look for glowing mushrooms or whatever so I can make my water filters and have pure water. Hello. All right, I'm back. Oh, apparently someone can't go to the bathroom for the viewers because they just dip out because, oh, he stopped for 5 minutes. Oh, well, your viewers. No, Fallout 76 doesn't suck. It's actually really good now. The series sucks on Amazon. You think I'd be streaming a game if it sucks so bad, dude? Like, I'm talking to you there, Odd Ed. And last I checked, only vacuums suck, dude. Yeah, that's right. Run away, Ed, you fucking loser. I'm gonna say this right fucking now. Anyone comes in here talking fucking shit about anything, gonna question the fact that, hey, why aren't you fucking trucking in your gaming? Or the fact that you're gonna question if a game sucks that I'm playing? I'll tell you right fucking now. The fucking door is that way. Don't let my foot kick you in the head on the way the fuck out, because I don't need your shit around here. I don't need your toxicity around here. I don't fucking take it, and I'm not fucking nice about it. So... opinions are like fucking assholes, and I'm the biggest asshole you're ever gonna fucking meet, so, fuck off. I wish my moderator was here for when that stupid question was popped. He would have kicked you a long fucking time ago.
Thank you.
Oh, I love having two creepers. You sit there and say nothing.
Sonny makes a good hoagie.
Haha, scared one away. Honestly, say hi or go away. I don't need a viewer sitting here hanging out all day. Like, it doesn't view, putting a view on my thing doesn't do anything. I hope you understand that. Thinking you're just hanging out watching does nothing for me. Like, I'm not here for your benefit. Because all you are to me, if you just sit there and creep and don't say hi about anything, you're just some creepy little stalker getting off on my voice.
Protect and serve